We're gonna make this line extra thick.
Extra thick. It's me.
Before the video starts, I'd like to announce that I will be attending two Comic-Cons in Memphis, Tennessee. The first is BeyondCon on May 4th. It is located on 1879 North Germantown Parkway. I will be co-hosting their How to Break Into Comics panel with Matt Bowen. There are also special guests such as Scott Ennis of Scooby-Doo fame and actor Creek Wilson of Twisted Metal. The second con is the Memphis Libraries Comic-Con at Benville Hooks Library on May 18th. This library is located on 3030 Poplar Avenue. The special guests for this event are Matt Ragnar, who is the creator of Grendel and works on stories with DC superheroes like Batman and Superman, and Gene Hall, another DC artist who also created his own independent comic, May. I hope to see you guys there. Now, on to the video.
Hello everyone, this is Devin from DS Cartoons. I'm here actually doing a little test art vlog today. So I'm going to ink this page here. This is from one of my comics. This is for a little scene called The Good and the Bad and the Sketchy. It just features some of my characters from one of my comics. It's called The Common Days of Cade. I know that a lot of YouTube subscribers that I have aren't really that familiar with my comics because I've been on a hiatus for almost 2 years. So I'll just give you guys a little rundown on it as I go ahead and start inking. Okay, so I personally like to erase certain parts of my drawing whenever I'm inking. And good thing I have a white box here that I forgot I even had for like a few years now. That's the wrong pen. Micron 03 pins. I know it's like kind of difficult to see just because I'm more left-handed. I might probably go ahead and try and do a different angle real quick.
20 minutes later.
Okay, I'm back, so I actually end up bettering the setup now to support me being left-handed. So, as I was saying, I'm actually making this for a zine series called The Good, The Bad, and The Sketchy. It's a small press local scene, at least local in the Memphis area, which is where I live in Memphis, Tennessee. They try to do a few of them every like year or so. And they currently have 7 issues out, and I actually did the cover for their last issue. But it's a lot of local cartoonists will make small comics based on a theme or prompt. So I want to say this issue's theme is a fairy tale theme. So we're just making fun little comics off of like popular fairy tales. So I chose to do Jack and the Beanstalk. And so the gag of this comic is that Cade, who's this character, and Laron, who's this character, they acquire magic beans and then they decide to go ahead and plant them. And then the punchline is that they waited so long waiting for a beanstalk to grow, but it never does. So that's like the simple one. I decided to just go ahead and ink this first panel because I don't really want this to be a very long vlog as I'm still testing out this setup and everything. And with that, I can go ahead and just talk more about The Common Days of Cade. Back in 2021, I actually decided to self-publish a comic book series, and its name is The Common Days of Cade, and it was originally based on a series of short stories I made for an old anthology prior to the one I'm working on now for a short-lived startup comic book company that took place in Memphis, Tennessee. I think I only did like 2 comics for them, but I ended up not really liking how they were operated, so I ended up moving to a self-publishing model after spending a few years trying to better up ideas to have it work as a standalone comic. And so, outside of these occasional short one-page gag comics, I actually have 2 full comic books. They're like full 22-page comics starring these characters out right now on my website if you're interested in buying it digital or physical. Shameless plug. But yeah, I actually end up enjoying making comics and it's like kind of a holdover from being on a hiatus for animation on YouTube. Go ahead, erase some more of these. Okay, yeah, so I've been on hiatus for about 2 years on YouTube due to burnout, because I originally tried to upload videos on TikTok, hoping to gain a following on there, but then I ended up not really enjoying it because I felt like I had to compromise a lot of the ideas I really wanted to do in favor of the types of videos. So in favor of the types of videos that are said to get you likes and follows over stuff you personally wanted to do. And that really kind of took a toll on me. So when I hate this and practically had these comics as like sort of a coping with that, and so far these comics I only just print like a few copies at a time. Reception wise they have really positive reception amongst the people who have read them. Mostly like a lot of people involved in a lot of nerd culture here in Memphis, as well as the comic cons, and I am hoping to kind of expand it more into other territories, and I do hope to check out some out of town cons in the future. And then I also got little reference images that I've made on how to properly design these characters. Key inspiration for these character designs, I often quote two artists, Tadashi Yamashita, known for doing a lot of Namco artwork of Namco characters, primarily Pac-Man, as he actually designed like the limb version of Pac-Man. And I always liked the way he used to draw. He always drew that version of Pac-Man where he had like broken outlines, and I thought it was a cool thing to add on these characters. And then the second artist I took inspiration from was Bob Boyle, who is known for designing Fairly Odd Parents characters, as well as creating one show for Disney called Yin Yang Yo, which kind of follows like his sort of character design philosophy, where you have very simplistic shapes, but the characters tend to be slightly expressive. And so I just kind of combine like things I personally enjoyed into the comics I've made so far. I'm gonna switch over to the number two pen real quick. This part here too. I get that little nose right there, the inner eye. Up right there, and then get fresh. Kind of partially tough to do it just because I have like really condensed space. So I have my pens and pencils here, and then my microphone on the side. Hopefully captured a lot of these voices, because I've been dealing with microphone issues. So I hope it's not too quiet when I go back and listen to it. If it is, then I can always go back and edit it in post. Yeah, I think I can probably talk about my plans for like YouTube going forward. So I personally don't have like a full plan going forward. I might just do these small vlog videos until I can get something up and going. And as for like Uncelebrated Discoveries, which was something I always talked about here and there, but I never really like went forward with it. I actually canceled that series because I didn't want to go towards the route of being a cartoon reviewer. I kind of prefer just making stuff rather than
critiquing popular shows and movies. And I just didn't really feel like going through the whole thing of having to constantly like watch shows in their entirety, which is something very common with a lot of YouTube reviewers, where if you review a show on there, especially like an older show, you're always expected to watch every single episode of it. Like, you just watch a small handful of episodes and decide to go in from there. A lot of people really wouldn't consider you like a very credible source for a critique. And then to also just, as I said, want to focus more on just making stuff, as I tend to be more passionate about creating things than just talking about like shows I've watched and things. I know like the outline seems a little clunky since I'm doing it flat, and ever since I had this drawing table, I always like drawing and inking slanted, so it might be a little odd here, but I can always fix it. I'm gonna go ahead and start out with Kate since he's the main character. So I kind of consider Kate more of an optimistic character, as he always tries to make the best out of the bad situations he's in. The first story I've made for the full book was that Kate actually discovers that when he wakes up, it's the last day of school, and so he decides to go and visit alone to see what they can do before they have to go back to school. Then Laurent is kind of like, I would consider him more as a wild card, so he's always down to whatever ideas Kate has. But Laurent can kind of sometimes cause mischief along the way, or like mischief can happen to him. Maybe starting to kind of, you guys have any art tips or things like just some stuff to take in consideration in the future regarding how I'm drawing or inking? You guys can feel free to leave them in the comments below. And then I also like to ask that if you guys are enjoying the video so far, to leave a like as well as subscribe to my page. I'm curious how long this is going to go. And hopefully the camera doesn't cut off on me if I'm done with this. Oh man, I'm just like realizing now. Then I might have to throw some light out on that. Those hands are like too, well, those fingers are like too deep in. Here comes pouring. Oh boy. Recording this at night. I'm already feeling tired. I've apparently been doing this for 27 minutes now. I'm also throwing some of this shine here. Okay, let's get started on this. I always have a habit of placing my work alone right in the pages themselves, because I know that some people will draw the comic out and then deal with work balloons during posts, especially during cleanups. Like for me, it's like, I always felt like it's a little better just drawing it on the pages themselves, just so I know where everything's gonna be ahead of time, versus having just the drawings there, and then when I move it to post, like digital, like get it scanned and everything, and find out that I have no room for balloons, I'll be practically screwed there. So that's why I always draw it on here. We're gonna make this line extra thick.
Extra thick.
Yeah. I think I'm probably gonna like stop it when I'm just done with the characters and not bother doing the panel lines. If anyone has any better suggestions on doing word balloons, you guys feel free to leave that in the comments as well. And then I think I'm on my last part of doing outlines. Oh great, I think my security camera notifications going off. I'm gonna go ahead and fix up some of these outlines here. And then bring out the trusty white outfit. I'm just let those part dry up for a little bit and just go use this brush pen. And so I do like the brush pen a lot. That's how I kind of get these sort of spot lines here. Switch over to Laurent real quick. And just to let you guys know, like, not everything is going to look perfect, but that's okay. Okay, so I'm just gonna leave it like this for the night. Thank you all for watching, and as I said before, I recommend, if you guys have enjoyed this video, that I recommend subscribing to the channel and clicking that bell icon, as well as leaving a like and a comment, and I'll see you guys next time.